Can Apple's latest M2 MacBook Air handle 6,000 Google Chrome tabs? Let's find out. Hey guys, how are you all doing? If you're new here, welcome. My name is Krazy Ken, and I just got done testing out this M2 MacBook Air in my first impressions episode, so feel free to check that out if you want. But I wanted to run this fun little experiment. It's been over 2 years since I've last tried it, and I thought, well, hey, Apple has a new computer out. Let's break it in with 6,000 Chrome tabs. You know, as do you do. Here's the interesting thing about this experiment. The last test subject was a 2013 Retina MacBook Pro with 16 gigs of RAM. This thing has only 8 gigs of RAM. It has only half the amount of memory, so will that affect the results in a negative way? Not sure. And I gotta thank Jonathan Morrison from TLD Today for making this script. It opens 1,000 tabs at a time, so let's bust it open and see if this thing can manage. Here's what I use to keep track of the tabs. It's just a simple Chrome extension called Chrome Tab Counter. And let's launch the Automator workflow. You guys ready? MacBook Air, are you ready? You better be. Run! There we go. As you can see, it is going absolutely bananas. Look at that. All the websites are just flying in. All the tabs are loading on top. And we'll see how long this thing can last. The Chrome tab counter is currently not even showing a number. Oh, wait, there it goes. 1,000, ladies and gentlemen. Both and neither. We have 1,000 tabs already, but they're still loading. Technically, yeah, we got up to 1,000, but we gotta let them load and see how it does. Holy, oh, just look at all of those loading indicators. Holy crap. Out of 8 gigs, we're already using 7.64, and the pressure is in the red. Hey, but the system is still functioning. It's running kind of slow. Each of these tabs, oh gosh, up here are using like 400, 435, 644 megabytes each. But yeah, I'm gonna give it a little more time to load in here, and then I'll run the script again. While we wait for a bit, I might as well mention I did do a first impressions episode about the M2 MacBook Air, and I also did a retrospective about the first MacBook Air from 2008. Both were really fun, so go check those out as well. Oh no, the trackpad's doing that thing where it's not clicking because it's not a physical button. It uses the Taptic engine to create haptic feedback when you press. But if the system is going too slow, you don't feel the click. Oh, it's so weird. The button is not responding. So what do you say, guys? Should we run the script again for another 1,000 Chrome tabs? Of course, let's try it. Here we go, execute. The button isn't working. There it goes, and it's running. Oh no, this is, oh, I am so sorry, M2. But you can do it. You gotta beat that 4,000. That's the number the counter got up to. Nope, the number is not changing yet. Let's check in on the memory pressure. Oh yeah, we're in the red. It went down a bit, you know, for a little while into the orange, and now it's absolutely going back up into the red. And there we are at 2,000 tabs. The counter has officially hit 2,000, and I wanted to zoom in, but the system is lagging pretty bad. So now that it's at 2,000, I'll give it a sec and then run the script again and see if we can get to 3,000. And here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1, bam. Going for 3,000. There it goes. The websites are coming in. Doesn't look like they're moving as fast as they were earlier, but we are putting a very unnecessarily, impractically large load on this poor system. All right, so here's the deal. The system is still responding. It's a little bit laggy, but it's still chugging along. Chrome, on the other hand, seems to be completely stuck because I haven't seen any of the loading wheels spin at all. And anytime I try to click on the tab counter extension, it does not open up the little sheet. So it looks like it's stuck trying to get to 3,000. An interesting thing though, even though it's not getting to a higher tab count yet, it's at least not freaking out too bad. I recall the older Intel system having some like checkerboard glitchy issues, and this system hasn't shown any of those glitches, but the number counter isn't going much higher. I'll give it some more time to think, but we may have to call this one soon, and it looks like this thing is gonna be beaten by my, let's see, 9-year-older laptop from 2013. You know, maybe it hasn't moved on along because I haven't motivated it enough like I did in the other episode. Maybe I gotta fan it off with a towel or something. But no, I thought about that. And I have a better idea. If you're hot, MacBook Air, you just need to cool off with the Blau portable AC, huh? Is that it? Yeah, I mean, hey, this thing can chill a whole room in 5 minutes, right? Certainly it can cool off a computer. Yeah, I don't think so. What a piece of crap this thing is.
Hey, we got 3,000. It made it to 3,000. It's going kind of slow.
You know what that means. This thing actually works. No, not really. It means that we can run it. It means we can run the automator script again. Let's run the script again. Switching into automator, nice mouse cursor lag. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Going for 4,000. Well, it has been almost a half hour and it's still stuck at 3,000. So I think this thing is coming to an end. I don't know how much further it's really gonna get, but for fun, let's try to push it even further. Even though the counter hasn't updated, let's try running the script one more time. I'm gonna click in the automator, and once it loads up here, I guess I already clicked the run button. Okay, it's going! So we'll see if we can push it along or create some weird catastrophic explosion, or maybe the universe will implode, I don't know. Holy crap! I didn't think that would actually do anything. It's at 4,000 now. Okay. So I guess this kinda technically means it's tied with the Retina MacBook Pro now. Well, if we can get it to 5,000, then it wins. Well, at least it wins against the Retina Pro. Once this is done running, I'm just gonna run it again. Okay, it bounced, so it is ready. Let's switch back into it, let it load, and 3, 2, 1, go. We are gonna run it yet again. You can see the tab hovering is actually working. It's lagging, but it's working. Yeah, it still feels kinda hot. But not too bad. Logic board temperature, 138 degrees, yeah. That is still cooler than it was during my video encoding test in that other MacBook Air episode. Okay, automator bounced, so it's done running. Yeah, it doesn't look like the extension wants to open. Gee, I wonder why. Maybe because all the memory is being used by Chrome tabs? Well, let's try loading one of those Chrome tabs to see if any of them are usable. Nope, I'm not getting any response. My mouse cursor is also not moving now. And the trackpad is also not clicking. Those are two perfect signs indicating that your computer is absolutely in a healthy condition. Oh, it's jumping around. Ooh, this is probably a tie with the other MacBook Pro. However, if I can successfully exit out of Chrome with a force quit, then maybe this one actually wins a little bit. I don't know how you score this thing. Now, last time when I was doing the experiment, I got that force quit window where it was like a mandatory thing. You had to quit an application. But ultimately, if I recall correctly, it wasn't even functioning properly. I had to hard shut down the computer. But let's see if we can actually force quit the application. So I pressed the command option escape keyboard shortcut. Let's see if we can summon the force quit window. My mouse cursor is not moving again. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I also just realized the clock was frozen for about 2 minutes. Now the screen is off. That's a good sign, right? No! You were about to win! You were about to beat the Retina! No! You might be tied with him now, because you shut yourself down! Oh, come on. Recover, recover. You can do it. I believe in you. Maybe 4,000 is just the magic number and you can't get past it. It's like completely off. It's not like rebooting or anything. Okay, I guess we'll just power it back up. I'm pressing the power button and it's not doing anything. Try it one more time. Oh, the keyboard backlight is on, so it's trying to do something. Okay, now the keyboard backlight is off. Oh, the screen looked like it turned on. Oh, there it goes. Hey, we got an Apple logo. Yeah, it must have crashed. I wonder if it was an actual kernel panic, though. I don't see the kernel panic screen, so let's see if it gives us an error when it boots up. Oh, yeah, your computer was restarted because of a problem. Let's hit report. And see what, oh, it did panic. It actually did panic. So panic CPU 3 caller code. Yeah, It did actually kernel panic, so impressive. Do I send this report to Apple and add a comment? Here, provide any necessary steps to reproduce the problem. Open 4,000 Google Chrome tabs. Maybe that will help the feedback team. And send to Apple. Oh my gosh, we have fun here. Restore pages. Chrome didn't shut down correctly. Do we dare click this restore button? Let's hit restore and see what it does. Oh no, it's beach balling. It's trying to, oh, there's all the, oh, we got 2,493 right now. So I guess it like was getting to 4,000, but maybe that's the amount that actually functioned properly. So that's the number it restored or something. I don't know. Holy crap, dude. These tabs are actually working. I can switch to them and they're actually doing stuff. Open tabs right here. We got like 2,000 and they're actually functioning. So now we have to go to a judge's decision. The M2 MacBook Air crashed before registering 6,000 tabs in the extension, so it did not pass the challenge. But did it at least beat the Retina MacBook Pro? The Retina MacBook Pro could not restore the tabs properly, and the M2 MacBook Air was able to restore over 2,400. So I am declaring the M2 MacBook Air the winner of this pointless contest. Nice job, man. You get to go in the Hall of Fame now. And man, this thing is thin and light. So cool. Anyway, again, if you want, feel free to check out my episode with my first impressions on this and my retrospective on the first generation MacBook Air as well. And I release new tech episodes every week, usually on Thursdays, because I like making episodes about rare and retro tech, new tech, and of course, scam tech. And hey, if you like this episode, you know what to do. Thanks, and I'll see you next time. Catch the crazy and pass it on.